Hello friends, in this series of bioprocess technology we have discussed a number of formulas, but still we are somewhere lacking in discussing formulas. I have seen that there are many other formulas which we are using in the gate biotechnology exam and are not discussed in this particular series. So what I am going to do is I am going to solve the numericals which are using some really different formulas which we have not discussed in the series, and we are going to understand the application and the derivation of those particular formulas in these videos which are about numericals. Okay, so today we are going to solve the numericals of Gate Biotechnology 2020 exam. Okay, that is the exam which appeared this year. Okay, so this is the first numerical and it says that a batch reactor is inoculated with 1 gram per liter biomass. Okay, so the inoculation amount is 1 gram per liter. Under these conditions, the cells exhibit a lag phase of 30 minutes. So there is a lag phase of 30 minutes. If specific growth rate in the log phase is 0.00417 per minute, the time taken for the biomass to increase to 8 gram is, okay. So he's saying that we inoculated the bioreactor with 1 gram of biomass per liter. Now how much time will it take to become 8 grams per liter? And they have given us specific growth rate and they have given us the period of lag time, that is 30 minutes. Now the formula which is used here, which you are directly going to use here, is mu is equals to ln nt by n naught divided by time. So okay, so this is the formula. You are going to transpose the time to the left hand side and make it for time, because we want to calculate here time. Okay, we want to calculate the time taken for biomass to increase to 8 grams. But where did we get this formula from? Okay, so we are going to do the derivation from this formula. Now we know that the rate of biomass production is dependent on or is directly proportional to the amount of biomass which is already present. Okay, so more the amount of biomass present or more the number of cells present, more will be the number of cells dividing and producing new cells. Okay, so if there are 10 cells present and the doubling time is 10 minutes, so after 10 minutes we are going to see 20 cells. Okay, so it depends on the initial number of cells. So what I am writing here is the rate of biomass production is directly proportional to the number of cells that are initially present. Now this number of cells, we can replace this number of cells by the amount of biomass also. Okay, so we can write that the rate of biomass production is directly proportional to the amount of biomass that is present. Okay, so both of these things are correct. So we are going to go with this particular term in this derivation and we are going to see how we can replace this x by n. Okay, so now if we remove this proportionality sign, we are going to get a constant, that is specific growth rate. Okay, so now this r, which is the rate of production of biomass per unit time, can be written as dx by dt. So this can be written as dx by dt is equals to mu x. Okay, so I'm going to transpose this x here, so dx by x multiplied by mu dt. Now integrate this from x to xt. Okay, so we are going to integrate it from x to xt. So x is the initial amount of biomass, so let me write it as x naught. From x naught to xt we integrate these, so we are going to get what? So we are going to get ln x naught to xt is equals to mu dt. So mu dt can be written as mu t ln xt minus ln x naught. Okay, now this ln xt minus ln x naught can be written as ln xt by ln x naught, which is equals to mu, and we can transpose the t on this side and it is going to be 1 by t. Okay, so this is the formula which we are going to use here. Okay, so if you see, the only difference in these formulas is here I have used the amount of biomass. So this is the amount of biomass which can be in grams, or which is can be the concentration of biomass. We can also use the concentration of biomass, given that the units and the numerator and the denominator should be same. Okay, it should be grams per liter, then this also is going to be grams per liter, and if it is kilograms per liter, this is also going to be kilograms per liter. Okay, so always look at the units. Okay, don't forget to look at the units. Always look at the units and convert them, convert all the units to a similar unit, okay, to the same unit. If the units are given in different forms, like one initial biomass concentration is given as grams per liter and final biomass concentration is given as kilograms per liter, so convert them make them same, and then only use in formulas. So we are going to use this particular formula, and here it is xt by x naught, and I've written, we can also write it as nt by n naught. So xt represents the amount of biomass at time t, nt represents the number of cells at time t. Okay, so we can do that because of this particular term. So you can derive this entire formula by using r is directly proportional to n, that is the initial number of cells, and by this way you're going to get this formula. So from this equation you're going to get this formula, and from this equation you get this formula. So what we are going to do is we are going to use this formula and solve this particular question. Okay, so let me rub this down, everything except the formula. Okay, so as I told you, we can replace this n by x, and here also, and I am replacing it by x. Now transport mu there, and we are going to get ln xt by x naught divided by mu, and now everything is given to us. Xt at time t, the biomass concentration, that is the final biomass concentration, is given to us as 8 grams per liter, okay, ln, divided by 1 gram per liter. Now always remember the units, okay, the units are same here, and mu is 0.00417. okay, so what we are going to get, we are going to get ln 8 divided by 0.00417, and now do not start calculating this terms by hand calculation, or do not start looking for a log chart or something. You are going to get a virtual calculator there, okay? During the gate biotechnology exam, you are going to get a virtual calculator on your screen. Use that virtual calculator, calculate the what is ln 8, and then divide it by 0.00417. I have seen many of my friends just hand calculating things. So this is ln, this cannot be calculated just like that, but I've seen many of my friends doing some additions, subtractions, divisions, and everything, the whole lot of things by hand. Please don't do that. You are going to get a virtual calculator, use that, okay? That is a facility given to you, use it. Okay, so when you calculate this, it is going to be something 498, okay? It is going to be something 498 point something, okay? Now this is the time which is taken for the biomass to grow. Okay, this is the time it is taken for the biomass to grow, but we are also going to add the lag phase time. Okay, so after the inoculum was added, there was a lag phase where there was no growth. Okay, in the lag phase there was no growth, and after that a mu was achieved, that is this, a mu was achieved, that is in the log phase. So first we know that there is a lag phase, and then there is a log phase. So they have given us time, so this is 30 minutes, and they have given us the mu in the log phase. So the mu is 0.00417 here, okay? The mu is 0.00417, and mu in the log phases, lag phase is almost zero. The mu in the lag phase is almost zero. So just remember that you have to add this time, okay? So this is the time, actual time of the log phase plus the time of the lag phase, and it is going to be 528, okay? So it is going to be 528 for something. And you know, for this particular question, there was a range of answer given, and it was something like from 526 to 529. So if your answer ranges between this particular range, it is correct, okay? So that was all about this question. Note this formula down in your notebook, and there is another question, so we are going to do that question now. Friends, this is the second question that was there in Gate Biotechnology 2020 exam, and this question is a bit tricky, okay? It is really simple. So it says that growth of an organism in a chemostrate on glucose is characterized by Monod's model with specific growth rate of 0.45 per hour. So it means that mu is given to us, that is 0.45 per hour. Ks is given. Biomass from the substrate is generated at a rate of, so yield is given to us. Chemostat volume is 0.9 liter, and the media is fed at, so chemostat volume is 0.9 liter, and the media is fed at 1.1 liter per hour. The feed rate is 1.1 liter, and the volume is 0.9 liter, okay? And contains 20 gram per liter of glucose, okay? Now it is asking at steady state, the concentration of biomass in the chemostat will be. So what will be the concentration of biomass in the chemostat? Now you need to remember one important concept for this question, okay? And that is, at steady state, mu is equals to D. So we have already discussed this many times that mu is equals to D, that is specific growth rate is equals to dilution rate, and that is when it is in steady state. Okay, under steady state mu is equals to D, and even if there is no steady state, mu is going to be always more than D. Okay, so dilution rate can be more than D, but at steady state concentration the dilution rate is always equal to specific growth rate. Okay, so we are going to do this numerical now. First we'll justify this particular term, and let us see. The chemostat volume is 0.9 and dilution rate is flow rate upon volume. Mu is here, so mu is given to us 0.45. What is the flow rate? The BDI is fed at 1.1 liter per hour. Okay, so 1.1 liter per hour, and it contains, and the volume is 0.9 liter. Volume is 0.9 liter. So if we take an approximation, it is going to be 0.45, which is not equal to, here also it is not equal to around 1. Okay, so if you see here, the dilution rate is much more than the mu. Okay, so in this question we find that the dilution rate is more than mu. It means there is washout occurring, there are no cells growing inside the bioreactor because there is a condition of washout. That means a large number of cells are being removed from the chemostat before they are generated. Okay, so it means that there is more removal of cells than growth of cells. There is more removal of cells than there is growth of cells. So this particular question tells us that there is a washout condition and the steady state biomass concentration is going to be a big zero. Okay, a steady state biomass concentration is going to be zero. So the answer to this question is zero. Don't just start calculating with putting different formulas. First read the question, then analyze the question and see if all the conditions of a bioprocess are being fulfilled. And even if you try to solve this question, probably you will have to use this mu as mu max. Okay, so this is specific growth rate. Also read the question carefully that this is specific growth rate, this is not maximum specific growth rate. I've seen my friends doing it. My friends were solving it like that mu is equals to, so they were doing something like this, that steady state substrate concentration is equals to KSB upon mu max minus B. So they were using this mu max and putting the value of 0.45, that is specific growth rate. So this is mu and this is mu max, so there is a difference. Okay, so we have solved the second question also of GATE 2020. So guys, please follow these videos, because here I am going to tell you different formulas by which you can solve the numericals. And also if you have any queries or questions, please do mention them in the comments. Okay, this comment box is for you. Please mention your suggestions. If you want any improvement in the videos, please mention that. And if you want further videos of any other subject, please also mention that. And also I am going to start very soon with biochemistry lecture series. So thank you.